Hello students, welcome to the next video under the topic of numerical methods. So in this video I'm going to teach about another method of numerical. It is regular falsi method. So it is an one more method to find a real root of nonlinear equations. So when you have to find the roots of the nonlinear equation, you can use this tool for the regular falsi. There are one more method also is there for Newton-Raphson method, which we have discussed in the last video. So first we will see the formula of regular falsi method. So the formula for regular falsi method is x is equal to a into f of b minus b into f of a by f of b minus f of a. So here a and b is nothing but from the nonlinear equation you can able to replace the value of x. For example 0, 1, 2, 3 like that, we can replace that f of x function where we are getting a cycle, that is nothing but the function value from negative to positive or positive to negative. We can able to choose that two values because your result must be, that is nothing but the roots must be in between of that two values. So which you are assuming that cycle value of f of x minus to plus or plus to minus, that corresponding x value will be taken, that a and b. So that is we can able to use it in this formula to get a further iterations. So obviously regular falsi also is an iteration method. So based on the requirement of the question, I can able to extend my iterations. So we can see that an example. Before into that, I want to share one information. If like A and B are close enough, that means which you are choosing that A and B is very close, we can obtain the approximate roots very quickly. That means you can avoid the iterations for to extending for 10 iterations or 20 iterations. So now we can see with one example. The example is compute the real root of the equation x log x to the base 10, which is equal to 1.2, correct to 4 decimal places. So now you can see that the question is clearly mentioned, the function f of x equation is given, but it is not an f of x is equal to 0 format. So I can take that 1.2 to the left side so that it will go equal to 0. And the question is asked to correct 4 decimal places. So depends on the requirement of your decimals to get for 4 decimal, you can extend your iterations. Now you have to check as a regular falsi method, I needed A and B value. For that I can able to check where I am getting a cycle, it is a negative to positive or positive to negative. For that, first I can consider my f of x, that is x log x to the base of 10, 1.2 will come to the left side, so it will be minus 1.2. Now you can replace x is equal to 0, I can get my f of 0 which is equal to 0. Then x is equal to 1, you can do f of 1 which is minus 1.2 which is less than of 0. Similar, you can do x is equal to 2, f of 2 value is a negative, minus 0.6. Then x is equal to 3, we will get f of 3, it is 0.23, it is a positive. Now you can see f of 2 value is a negative, f of 3 is a positive value. So your answer must be in between of the 2 and 3. Since it is a negative to positive, immediately it is changing it. So as I told us in the note, what is that? The A and B are close enough, we can calculate the approximate value quickly. For that reason, I'm extending the same step by taking it the decimal. First decimal I'm started considering. So as we know, the roots lies between 2, 3. So now we can start with 2.1. So replace in same function x log x minus 1.2. And f of 2.1 I will get minus 0.5233. Similar, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, 2.5, 2.6 and 2.7. Yeah, 2.8 I am getting a positive value. So you can see 2.7 and 2.8, I'm getting a negative to positive. So you can able to tell the root lies between. Some more we are close to the result. It is 2.7 and 2.8. So now you can fix 2.7 as an A, 2.8 is in your B. Now your first iteration will start because it is supposed to be find out your accurate 4 decimal. So I can take my A value is 2.7, B is 2.8, that corresponding F functions values also we have already done it. So just I have displayed. Now you can go for your X1. So X1 the formula is A F of B minus B F of A by F of B minus F of A, that is 2.7 of 0.520 minus 2.8 of minus 0.0353 by your F of B value and F of A value. So you can use the calculator to find out your X value. So what is your X1? It is 2.7404. So using that F1, before into your next iteration, I want to check the next A and B value. For that, again, I need to make it mandatory, which you have got it a recent value as in one value, either it will be A or B. So next one I have to find out. For that reason, I have to check this F of X value is a positive or negative. Based on that, I can take it which supposed to be A value or B value. Now you can see F of X1, it is F of 2.7404. So which is a negative value. So what we did in the previous one, so the positive value where you are having it, it is a 2.8, because 2.7 is giving in the negative value. So I needed the next cycle positive to negative value. So I can remove the 2.7 in A. Instead of that, I can replace A is nothing but X1 here. So what is that? The next root lies between 2.7404, 2.8. So using that A and B, I can substitute in the X2 formula and you can calculate, I can get X2 is 2.7404. Now I need to go for next iteration because it's not getting matched for your 4 decimal. So for that reason, again, I can go F of X2 as usual, what we did in the previous iteration. So what is that? F of X2, I'm getting F of 2.7406 is minus of 404, which is also a negative. So now you can remove your X1 because X2 you're supposed to fix it. The X2 and the positive is nothing but your 2.8. So now the root lies between 2.7406, 2.8. So now you can use this A and B, find out your X3. So we already have found it, your F of A and F of B. Just you can substitute, you can get your X3 value. So what is your X3? It is a 2.740646. So now you can compare your X2 and X3. 4 decimal is getting matched. What is that? 2.7406. So the approximate root of the given function is 2.7406. So this is an example for regular falsi. So we'll go one more example, which is you have a equation of x cubed minus 2x minus 5 is equal to 0. So I'll read the question. So use the regular falsi method to find a real root of the equation x cubed minus 2x minus 5 is equal to 0, correct to 3 decimal places. So the previous one we have a logarithmic function, this is I have an algebraic equation, and the question you have to correct to 3 decimal places. Now you can match only 3 decimal is enough. So we'll start with a solution. What is that? F of x is x cubed minus 2x minus 5. So what you have to do, you have to check where you are having a cycle of negative to positive or positive to negative. So replace 0, 1, 2, 3. So I'm getting F of 2 is a negative value, F of 3 is a positive value. Now the root lies between 2 and 3. So to make it accurate and to reduce your iteration, I can start with a decimal. 2.1 I can replace. Immediately I got as a negative, where f of 2 is in have a negative. 2.1 I got it as a positive. So therefore the roots lies in 2, 2.1. So now using this a and b, I can go my first iteration. So yeah, you know already a, b, f of a and f of b. So I can go with the formula of your x1, substitute your a and b, I can get my x1, what is that? 2.0943. So your f of x1 immediately you have to calculate, because we need to go for your next iteration. It is a minus 0.00281, which is a negative value. Now you can go for next iteration. So it is nothing but you have a negative of a value. What is that? I have a negative f of x1. So where you have a positive value, x1 is supposed to fix it. And I need to go for your, what is that? The previous value, so positive is nothing but 2.1. So the next root lies between 2.0943, 2.1. So now using this a and b, you can substitute the formula and calculate. You can reach the answer is 2.0946. So therefore, compare your first and second iteration. Exactly 3 decimal is matching. So you can stop the iteration. The required approximate root is x is equal to 2.094. Okay. Now I can conclude the solution. So that's all. So I have given some sample questions for the practice. So you can practice it. So the first question, you can take it. Cos x minus 3x plus 1 equal to 0. I have mentioned the answer. And the second one, it's find the fourth root of 12. So what you have to do, hint also I've given, x supposed to be considered as an fourth square root, right? Fourth root of 12. So answer also I mentioned. Similar, you have a one more question. It is a normal algebraic equation. Find the root of the equation as x cube minus 4x minus 9 equal to 0. Here also you have to do correctly 3 decimal. So all the 3 problem, please practice and verify whether you are getting an answer. Okay, thank you. That's all. So keep practice all the problems.